Secretary, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Sri C. K. Misra. Director General of Forest and Special Secretary, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Sri Siddhant Das. Director and faculty members of the Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy, probationers of the Indian Forest Service. I welcome you all to Rashtrapati Bhavan and congratulate you for your selection to the Indian Forest Service. All of you have worked very hard to win a place in this premier service, and I wish you a successful career. Your service is unique. Its fundamental call for action falls in the very genesis of life itself. Can we imagine life without forest, without trees, plants, birds, or animals? It is difficult to even imagine this very building where you are sitting, that is Rashtrapati Bhavan and the President's estate, without its lush green trees, beautiful peacocks, and greenery. Forests are fundamental to the very existence of life on our planet. हम सभी जानते भी हैं कि वनों के साथ हम सब भारतवासियों की आत्मीयता सदियों से जुड़ी हुई है। हमारी सभ्यता को उसकी बौद्धिक और आध्यात्मिक शक्ति वनों से प्राप्त हुई। हमारे लिए वन कोई संसाधन मात्र नहीं है, बल्कि हमारी सांस्कृतिक, आध्यात्मिक और बौद्धिक विरासत का हिस्सा है। फिर भी हमें इस बात पर विचार करना होगा कि अपनी वन संपदा को क्या हम यथोचित संरक्षण, सम्मान और देखभाल प्रदान कर पा रहे हैं। हमें केवल वन संपदा के हित में वनों की संरक्षा की जरूरत नहीं है, बल्कि अपने स्वयं के हित के लिए और इस धरती पर बसे सभी जीवधारियों के लिए वनों की रक्षा हम सबको करनी होगी। हम सब लोग ये भी जानते हैं कि एक वृक्ष होता है या वृक्षों का समूह, जिसे वन कहा जाता है, इनकी जो मूल प्रवृत्ति होती है वो देते रहने की होती है। एक वृक्ष को यदि हम लें, ऑक्सीजन देता है। कुछ वृक्ष तो इस प्रकार के हैं, लाइक पीपल, जो कि 24 आवर्स हमें ऑक्सीजन देते हैं, छाया देते हैं, फल देते हैं, और जब वो पेड़ सूख जाता है तो उसके पश्चात वो हमें लकड़ी भी देता है। अर्थात ये जो देने की प्रवृत्ति है, ये हम सबको वनों से सीखनी है, और इसलिए मैं आप सब से अनुरोध जरूर करूँगा कि आप, यू हैव चूजन वन ऑफ द फाइनेस्ट सर्विस ऑफ इंडिया, जो वी मस्ट कंटिन्यू टू थिंक द कंसेप्ट ऑफ गिविंग बैक टू द सोसाइटी, गिविंग बैक टू द नेशन, इन व्हाट एवर मैनर वी कैन अफोर्ड। एक कोइंसिडेंस, आई हैड रिसेंटली द प्रिविलेज टू विजिट वन कंट्री इन लैटिन अमेरिका, दैट इज सूरीनाम। आई सॉ विद माय ओन आईज, इट इज दिस कंट्री इज कवर्ड विद फॉरेस्ट एरिया, वी कैन से 90% प्लस, एंड इफ यू हैपन टू विजिट this country, and I will advise you, just find some time if you plan to go there and see the beauty. It's a wonderful country. And that prompted me to visit one of the districts in India. And I was told in Chhattisgarh, Bastar happens. Bastar is the one of the biggest district of India. it is also full of forest. So I will be visiting, I think after 2 days, and will be staying there also, and to not only to enjoy, but to see the natural beauty and to live with the tribals. Imagine their difficulties in which they live, and whatever we can do, we should do. एक कोइंसिडेंस और भी है आपकी सर्विस का. अभी मुझे याद आ रहा था कि इवन वन ऑफ ए सीनियर ऑफिसर फ्रॉम योर कैडर, ही इज सर्विंग राष्ट्रपति भवन एज ज्वाइंट सेक्रेटरी, एंड आई थिंक ही इज सिटिंग हियर आल्सो. यस, ओवर द पास्ट फ्यू डिकेड्स द वर्ल्ड हैज रियलाइज द एक्सटेंशियल थ्रेट्स posed by environmental degradation, depletion in forest cover, and above all, global warming leading to climate change. And that is why the government of India preferred to create a ministry in the name of climate change. Environmental protection has become a key concern for the 21st century. And forests are an integral part of the solution. Forests, being a potential carbon sink, could help us reduce greenhouse gases in the atmosphere and the threat of global warming. Forests can play a critical role in mitigating the adverse effects of climate change. Watersheds with good forest cover insulate areas from droughts and enhance productivity of agriculture. Mangroves protect coastal areas from cyclones and tsunamis, and forests on the hill slopes protect the soil and prevent landslides and flash floods. Forest protection, especially in India, must invoke participation and support of those whose livelihoods depend on forests. A large number of very poor people, including tribals, live in and around the forests in our country. It is through forests that they fulfill their basic needs of food, fuel wood, and fodder. These people are simple and hardworking, and they are very wise. They respect forest as part of their traditions and beliefs. Any measures to protect forest should be sensitive to the basic needs of these people and involve them as partners. These communities can be your ears and eyes against poaching and illegal logging. You need to guide them and reassure them about their forest rights and their safety. The joint forest management model that we have adopted is based on the care and share principle. It envisages a partnership with local people and communities in the management of forests. You must involve these people and communities in forest management and apply the scientific principles of forestry with a human and compassionate face. This alone will provide solutions that are sustainable and effective. All of you shall be responsible for environmental and ecological conservation. This is a supremely important objective. Your actions and your work will leave an imprint for generations to come and influence how our civilization evolves. As bearers of public trust, discharge your duties with utmost diligence, honesty, and integrity. Your success will be judged by the way you conduct yourself in your long career. India is one of the fastest growing economies in the world, and we have set ourselves for rapid economic progress. However, what we seek is sustainable development. While this may not always be an easy task, I am confident that you would emerge as solution providers who shall help our country achieve the fine balance between conservation needs and development goals. Once again, I wish you all a long and fulfilling career. Jai Hind.